schedules of reinforcement. Reinforcement is a kind of gift or reward which are given by the reinforcers to initiate the likelihood of good behavior or pleasant behavior. So reinforcement can be provided through a program. That program is called as schedules of reinforcement. So learning is usually most rapid, or learning is usually enhanced if the response is reinforced each time when it occurs. So this kind of reinforcement is known as what? A continuous reinforcement. Reinforcement schedule can be provided into two ways, which are continuous reinforcement and intermittent or partial reinforcement. Continuous reinforcement means it is a continuous provision of reinforcement by the rewarders. He can be a teacher, they can be parents, whoever they are, they can provide a continuous and then stopping reinforcement in order to enhance or in order to initiate the likelihood of that specific behavior. On the other hand, if we have a shortage of praise or reward, it is possible to provide intermittent or partial reinforcement. So we can use either continuous or intermittent or partial reinforcement. There are four types of intermittent schedules. As I said before, continuous reinforcement is a process of providing rewards continuously in every time or in every response. However, intermittent or partial reinforcement is provided sparingly or sometimes. So the two are different. One is continuous, the other one is sometimes. So these intermittent schedules or intermittent reinforcement can be classified into four. Let us see them one by one. The first one is fixed ratio schedules. Fixed ratio schedule means reinforcement is given in terms of response, in terms of action, in terms of product, which is observed from the students or an individual. So fixed ratio schedule is a schedule of reinforcement that occurs after a fixed number of responses. However, these kinds of reinforcement facilitates or enhances, or it shows high rates of responding or actions. So especially in different big organizations or companies, employers often used fixed ratio schedules to increase or to level up the productivity of that organization. So an interesting feature of a fixed ratio schedule is that performance sometimes drop off just after the reinforcement. This is the weakness or the drawback of a fixed ratio schedule. For example, parents can reinforce their children in terms of reading of page numbers. For example, a parent can reinforce his child or his child every 10 pages. 10 pages, 20 pages, 30 pages, 40 pages. Every 10 page variation, if a child reaches the expected pace, he will be or she will be rewarded. So such kind of reinforcement is called a fixed ratio schedule. The second one is variable ratio schedule. The response will be varied. A variable ratio schedule of reinforcement occurs after some average number of response, but the number varies from reinforcement to reinforcement. A variable ratio schedule of products extremely high rates of improvement. So the response are more resistance to extinction than when a fixed ratio schedule is used. When we compare variable ratio and fixed ratio, variable ratio is more productive than fixed ratio instead of, you know, increasing the likelihood of the expected behavior or the likelihood of pleasant behavior. For example, parents can reinforce their children in terms of different page numbers. But the page number, the page numbers are not expected. Parents can reinforce their children when they read 10 pages, when they read 16 pages, when they read 25 pages, when they read 40 pages. So students or children may not know when they will be rewarded. So what they will do is just continuing their reading. So variable ratio is more productive than the fixed ratio. In the case of fixed ratio, students will expect the reward every 10 pages. But in the case of variable ratio, when they will be rewarded, they don't know. So what they should do is simply reading, and get the expected reward. The other types of intermittent or partial reward or schedule is fixed interval schedule. This is rewarded in terms of time, not in terms of response. A fixed interval schedule of reinforcement occurs only if a fixed amount of time has passed since the previous reinforcers. Parents can reinforce their children based on time. What kind of time? Fixed time. Every 2 hours, they reward their child for the first time at 2 hours, then at 4 hours, 6 hours, 8 hours, 10 hours, 12 hours, 14 hours. Such kinds of fixed type time scheduling is fixed schedule. The last one is variable interval schedule. A variable interval schedule of the reinforcement occurs only a variable amount of time. The time is not known. For example, parents can reinforce their children based on different or variable time. First, they can reward at 2 hours, then 5 hours, 7 hours, 10 hours, 12 hours, 15 hours, 17 hours. We don't know when they will be rewarded. So when we compare variable interval schedule with fixed interval schedule, variable interval is more effective than fixed interval. So these are the reinforcement schedules. A basic principles of operant conditioning is that if you wanted to a response to persist after it has been learned, you should reinforce it intermittently, not continuously. According to operant conditioning, parents, teachers, organizational managers, and leaders are suggested or encouraged to apply intermittent reinforcement instead of using a continuous reinforcement schedule, because intermittent schedule has paramount importance in the persistence of the response as well as behavioral change of the individual. Okay.